Good morning to all of you. In our last class, we have been discussed about Fraunhofer diffraction by double slit experiment. In our first discussion, we have been discussed that for diffraction pattern or in case of a double slit experiment, the diffraction pattern will be observed due to diffraction and as well as interference. The mathematical derivations that we have been found that the intensity or the resultant intensity on the screen will be observed due to diffraction as well as interference. So how it will be, that we are going to be discuss in this discussion, in this video. Let's we have to start. In our last class, we have been discussed that the arrangement of double slit experiment, double slit diffraction by Fraunhofer experiment, there is the two slits here, AB and CD, two slits separated by a opaque, that is BC. When the light ray will be incident through AB slit, the ray will be pass straight way and some ray will be diffracted along A dash Q. Likewise, through CD slit, some of the ray passed without diffraction and some ray with diffraction, that D dash Q, or we can say C dash Q, like diffraction ray we can found from this slit, due to which at point Q we can found both diffraction pattern as well as interference due to this two rays which is passing through AB slit and CD slit, as like Young's double slit experiment that we have been discussed. So in detail with mathematical derivation we have been discussed, and at last we found that the intensity, the resultant intensity, is nothing but that we can found 4 into a square sin square alpha into cos square beta. So here 4 into a square sin square alpha, or a square sin square alpha by alpha square, is represents the diffraction intensity, cos square beta represents the interference intensity pattern. Then if we have to consider only diffraction intensity distribution due to diffraction or due to a square sin square by alpha square, we found that alpha equal to plus or minus n lambda, and here if we are going to put alpha as pi a sin theta by lambda, then it will be a sin theta by plus or minus n lambda. This is the condition for secondary minima for the diffraction pattern, that is this one. These are minima. That means at n pi we are going to get here, see, at n pi the path difference, the a sin theta or alpha should have to be plus or minus n pi. So if we are going to take along x axis alpha, at pi this is pi and this is 2 pi, this is 3 pi and this is 5 pi by 2, 3 pi and at 4 pi, all are the minima for the diffraction pattern, and here 3 pi by 2 is the maxima, the secondary maxima, 5 pi by 2 is the secondary maxima, 7 pi by 2 also the secondary maxima. Along positive x axis, what we are going to get, symmetry fringes or symmetry intensity also we are going to get on the other side of the origin. if it will be origin, whatever the fringe or peak we are going to be observed in this side, exactly the mirror reflection or symmetric of this peak we are going to get the peaks in other side of the origin. So this is pi, this is this is minus pi, this is 3 pi by 2, okay, this is minus 2 pi, this is minus 3 pi by 2, this is 3 pi, this is 7 pi by 5 pi by 2, and like that we can consider. So this pattern is nothing but the so-called due to diffraction. Now if we are going to consider the intensity distribution due to interference, then what we are going to get? We can get that we know that cos square beta, that cos square beta is the term which indicates about the interference, that due to cos square beta. So if we are going to take beta along x axis and cos square along y axis, cos square beta along y axis, the fringes or the peaks will be like this. That means for the bright cos square beta will be 1 and beta is equal to plus or minus m pi. So here m equal to 0, 1 pi, 2 pi. So 0 will be maxima pi, maxima 2 pi, maxima 3 pi, maxima 4 pi, maxima and other pi by 2. At pi by 2, 3 pi by 2, 4 pi by 2, and its corresponding negative x axis also we are going to get corresponding maxima and minima. So integral multiple of pi we are going to get the maxima. So here all multiple of pi by 2 we are going to get the minima of the interference pattern. Now here the resultant intensity due to the double slit experiment can be decided due to this pattern and this pattern also. Both when they have to be mixed, then we are going to get the resultant pattern. So I am going to show you one example that we are going to be discuss also in detail like this. See, this is our diffraction, this is our interference, and what will be the mixture if we are going to consider both sin square alpha by alpha square, the diffraction pattern, and this is the so-called due to our interference. If they are going to be mixed, then what type of pattern is going to be observed here, that we are going to be discuss now. So here we have found beta equal to plus or minus m pi, or we can say beta is nothing but pi by lambda a plus b sin theta. That is written in our initial, at the time of initial discussion here. In case of equation number 1a, you can found we have been considered beta is nothing but pi by lambda a plus b sin theta. Same thing we have been considered here, pi by lambda, this is pi, okay, this is pi, pi by lambda a plus b sin theta is equal to plus or minus m lambda, okay. Let this equation number is 3b, no problem. Here also simplify, after simplification we can get a plus b sin theta is equal to plus or minus m lambda. Let this equation is 4. Here m is equal to 0, 1, 2, 3, like that. Now what we have been discussed just before, that the resultant intensity distribution will be depends on both sin square alpha by alpha square and cos square beta terms. Just before we have been discussed. Now for to solve this one, or to find the resultant intensity, here what we consider, You just watch. If the position of certain interference maxima correspond to the diffraction minima at same position of the screen, then interference maxima will be absent. That means, another thing I want to tell to you, that the intensity in case of diffraction at the center is much larger as compared with this one, as compared with interference. So if somehow we can expect that somehow or somewhere the diffraction minima, if will be matched or overlap with any maxima of the interference, then this maxima will be cancelled out, will be not observed, could not be observed on the screen. Because if this maxima is matched with this minima here of the diffraction, this then this maxima will be suppressed. Okay, so this maxima will be missed out from the fringe. So same thing it has been written, that if the position of certain interference maxima means this one, these are the interference maxima, if any maxima of the interference pattern is going to be interference maxima correspond to the diffraction minima at the same position, if the position of certain interference maxima corresponds to or we can write overlaps, or we can write or here slash, you have to write overlaps to diffraction minima at a point or at the same position of the screen, at the same position or at a point, we can say at a particular point, if we can expect interference maxima overlap with a diffraction minima on the screen, then interference maxima which is overlapped with minima of the diffraction pattern will be absent, will be cancelled out. Okay, now why it will be cancelled out? Because this intensity is lesser than this intensity. So if this minima is going to be matched or overlapped with some of the maxima, then this maxima will be cancelled out. Assuming these things, suppose we have to consider theta as the angle, theta as the any angle, suppose any theta angle, here we have been considered along x axis theta. Here also similarly we can consider at any angle theta, interference, suppose at theta angle, comma, here comma we have to put, interference maxima matches with diffraction minima. Suppose at theta angle, any of the interference maxima matches with diffraction minima. That is, we can say that this is a condition for the interference maxima. See, a plus here beta is equal to plus or minus m pi is nothing but your maxima condition for the interference. See, beta is equal to m pi, condition for the maxima. Okay, for the bright fringe, beta is equal to plus or minus m pi, or we can say a plus b sin theta is equal to m pi. This is the condition for the maxima of the interference pattern. So here, for the interference pattern, the maxima condition is this one. Okay. Likewise, in case of diffraction, the minima condition is this one, a sin theta is equal to plus or minus n lambda. This is the minima condition. Here, in this equation, and in this equation, sin theta is common. Only for that, we have been assumed that at any angle theta, the maxima of the interference pattern is going to be matched with minima of diffraction pattern. That means here sin theta will be equal to this sin theta. Okay, here there is no equal, this is not equal. Here if we are going to consider sin theta is equal to plus or minus m lambda by a plus b, will be equal to this sin theta, because we are considering at an angle theta the corresponding interference maxima will be equal to corresponding diffraction minima. So here sin theta is equal to plus or minus m lambda by a plus b will be equal to this sin theta, that is plus or minus n lambda by a. So here for this sin theta, for this case, what will be the sin theta? For this case, the sin theta will be the same, because theta we have been considered both the case same. That theta, this theta is belongs to interference maxima but diffraction minima. Okay, so now sin theta will be equal to plus or minus m lambda by a plus b is equal to plus or minus n lambda by a. That implies this equal to this. That implies m equal to plus, this is plus, initially whenever I given the note it was written in minus, this is not minus, this is plus. A plus b gone this side, here lambda lambda got cancelled. A plus b by a into n, so m is equal to m equal to a plus b by a into n. Here n is equal to 1 2 3 dot 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 dot. Okay, that means this is the order of this m is nothing but the order of interference maxima. Here n is nothing but order of diffraction minima. Okay, this m is order of interference maxima, this n is order of interference minima. Here we can write m is order of interference maxima, and n is order of diffraction minima. Okay, so these things you have to be insert in your note. Okay, next we have to consider case 1. Now the important discussion is started, carefully you have to watch. Now we have to consider case 1. In this case 1, we have been considered here b is equal to a, b equal to a, that means slit width is equal to opaque width. This one, from your in your figure you can see this width of the slit is equal to opaque width. Okay, for this condition what will be happen here, if we are going to be put b equal to a here, we found that m equal to 2n, m equal to 2n. Now m equal to 2 4 6, for n equal to 1 2 3 4, like that. So here we got m equal to 2 4 6 for n equal to 1 2 3. What is the meaning of that? Here I written. Carefully you have to write this one. Here M is nothing but, we discussed, that is the order of interference maxima. N is the order of diffraction minima. So from this relation we found that for first minima diffraction is equal to, if I am going to put n equal to 1, that is nothing but first minima diffraction is equal to second maxima of interference. That in this figure I can show you the first diffraction minima, this one, this is the first diffraction minima, is matches with second interference maxima. This is the first, second interference maxima. That means if we have to consider this case B equal to A, then these fringes are going to be composited with each other or combined with each other. When combined, we can found this maxima will be false at here, the minima of the diffraction pattern. Where the minima of the diffraction pattern observed, there the maxima, second maxima, this is the first maxima of the diffraction, this is the second maxima of, sorry, this is the first minima of the diffraction, this is the second maxima of the interference. So this second maxima will be false on the first minima of the diffraction. First minima of the diffraction for the condition B equal to A. Likewise, if we have to put N is equal to 2, that means second minima diffraction is equal to M equal to 4 will be fourth maxima of interference. Likewise, third, if we have to put N equal to 3, that means third minima of diffraction will be, here equal means matches or false, you can say, matches with sixth maxima of interference. So now if these things is going to be happens, then what will be the resultant fringe pattern will be, that we are going to be discuss. See, here initially whenever I given the note, actually this figure is going to modify somewhat, that I am going to discuss. This figure will be not exactly like this, somewhat modification required for this figure I am going to show you. So for this case 1, what we found first diffraction, this is the first diffraction first minima diffraction is equal to second maxima interference. Here first minima diffraction will be overlap with second maxima of the interference, like this. That means this peak is going to be overlap here. Likewise, left side also, this peak, this is the first, second peak is going to be overlap at this minima. Okay, if this two peak is going to be here, then these three peaks will be where? Will be in this envelope. Again, you have to watch carefully. If I am going to put this much, only this much portion, you have to consider this much portion. So minima is overlap with second maxima of interference. Likewise, in the left hand side also we can consider minima, first minima will be overlap with the second maxima of the interference. If these two will be here, then these three will be inside this envelope. Okay, that means it will be, when this will be combined with each other for the condition A equal to B, then these three peaks will be observed in this. This is the resultant one. This is the combination of this. If we are going to consider this is the resultant, then it will like this. Okay. That means these three peaks will be observed in this envelope, in this central envelope, like this. Okay. Gone. This much over. Now we have to consider second one. Second one means fourth maxima will be matches or overlap with second minima diffraction. Second diffraction minima or minima diffraction. Whatever you can write here. Okay. So fourth maxima of interference is matches with second minima of diffraction. So what is the second minima? This is the second minima. Will be matches with fourth maxima. That is, fourth maxima means 1, 2, 3, 4. This one. This will be matches with this one. Likewise, in the left hand side also we can consider second minima matches with 1, 2, 3, 4. That means, see, this two peak will be matches, will be like this. Here it has to come here, second minima. Okay, and this two peak will be come to the first minima. When this will be happens, then these three peaks of the interference maxima will be observed in this envelope, these three maxima interference. Likewise, when this minima will be moved to here and this minima will be moved to here, in between that only one peak is observed, and this will be observed in which envelope? This will be go inside this envelope. And likewise, this peak will be go inside this envelope. Okay. So now what will the pattern? Like this. Inside the diffraction, one interference pattern. Inside the diffraction, one interference pattern. Okay. Now, if we have to consider, if we are consider third minima diffraction will matches with the sixth maxima of interference, then what will happen? Third minima, this is the first, second, third. Third will be matches with the sixth one. This is the 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. This third will matches with this one. Minima matches with maxima means this maxima will be not observed. This will be cancelled out. Okay. Likewise, here third minima will matches with the sixth one. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. This is 6. So in between that, what is the peak observed? Fifth one. That one, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. This is not cancelled out. This will be cancelled out because this is matches with minima. So this will be inside this envelope. Okay. Likewise, this side, we can also consider this peak will be observed inside this envelope. Okay. So resultant will be like this. Similarly, if we are going to consider higher order minima corresponding higher order maxima, then also we are going to get like this. Like this. In one diffraction envelope, this is the one diffraction envelope, this one. This is envelope of diffraction. Okay, this is, we can say, P peak of the interference. In one diffraction envelope, we got 1-1 interference peak. 1-1 interference peak. Like this. Like this. Like this. Like this. Like this. Okay. So this will be the resultant intensity distribution when A equal to B. So this figure, whatever I given to you initially in the note, that is going to be changed. This is going to be changed as this one. Okay. That means inside the first middle envelope, three peaks will be there. It is okay. But inside this, only one peak has to be observed. Here it is three peak observed. No, it will be one peak has to be observed. Here, one peak. So you have to correct it. Only one peak has to be observed. Here also only one peak. Inside the diffraction envelope, only one peak. Inside the diffraction, only one peak. Okay. So here, inside this envelope, diffraction envelope, only one peak has to be observed. And here also, only one peak has to be observed. One peak has to be observed. So this is so-called theta. That is okay. Pi minus 3 pi by 2, 2 pi by 2 pi, no problem. Okay. So for this condition, the resultant intensity distribution due to double slit diffraction will be like this. At the central diffraction envelope or inside the central diffraction envelope, we can observe three interference maxima. And other diffraction envelope, inside the other diffraction envelope, this is another envelope of diffraction, only one interference peak has been observed. Others are cancelled out because they are matched with minima of the diffraction pattern. Okay, this is one condition. Another condition we are going to be consider, that if case 2, it is somewhat interesting. Okay, so case 2, B is equal to 2A. If we are going to consider B is equal to 2A, then what will happen? Here we have been considered B is equal to 2A. That means the opacity, the opaque region, this one, is twice increased as compared to this slit width. If this width, if I am going to increase, then what will the fringe pattern will be changed, that we are going to be discuss. So as per the relation of this one, m is equal to a plus b by a into n, that we are going to write first here. M is equal to a plus b by a into n. Okay. A, n. So here we have been considered that b is equal to 2a. That implies m equal to a plus 2a by a into n. That implies m equal to a plus 2a, 3a by a, that equal 3n. So m is equal to 3n. M equal to 3n. So we found that if b equal to 2a, then m equal to 3n. Okay. Then m equal to 3n, because as per the relation of m is equal to a plus b by a into n, and here we have to consider that m equal to a plus b equal to 2 into a by a into n, then it will be equal to m equal to 3n. Okay. If m equal to 3n and here n equal to here n equal to 1, 2, 3, dot 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 dot. For corresponding n is equal to 1, m equal to 3, corresponding to n equal to 2, m equal to 6. That means n is represents the minima of the diffraction. Here m is represents the order of the maxima of the interference. So here n is equal to 1 to 3, and here n is correspond to minima, diffraction minima. Okay, this is the 1 2 3 is the order of diffraction minima. So here n is equal to 1 is matches with 3. That means first order diffraction minima is equal to or matches with third order interference maxima. Third order interference maxima. Likewise, second order diffraction minima, second order diffraction minima, second order diffraction minima, this is minima, written in minima. So second order diffraction minima matches with sixth order interference maxima. Sixth order interference maxima. Okay. Likewise, third order minima in diffraction minima is matches with ninth order interference maxima. So here first order minima, third order maxima, second order minima, sixth order maxima, third order minima, ninth order maxima, they are going to be matched. So if it is so, then what will be the fringe pattern that we are going to be discuss? So in which way we have been done first one, the second one, that is for b equal to 2a, for this condition also we are going to be do in the same way. See, here first order minima is matches with third order maxima of the interference. That means, see, first order minima is this one, will be matches with the third order maxima of the interference. This is the first, second, third. That means this, so this will be matches with 1, 2, 3, this one. Okay. If this maxima is going to match with minima, then this maxima will be not observed, cancelled out. Likewise, left hand side also the same scenario. 1, 1, 2, 3 will be matches with the first. This will be also cancelled out. Okay. So if it is so, then in this envelope, how many interference peaks will be observed? See, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. It will like this. See, so this peaks 1, 2, this side 1, 2, middle is 1. 5 interference peaks is going to be observed in this envelope, like this. 1, 2, 3, this is middle one, likewise this side also. How many peaks we observed? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, these peaks, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, these peaks will be observed in this envelope, and we found this one. So now we have to consider what will be the scenario for this one, for this peak. That means we have to consider second minima will be matches with what? See, second minima, second order diffraction minima is equal to sixth order interference maxima. Sixth order, that means it is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. This is 6. This could not be observed. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. This could not be observed because this minima, this is the second, first, second minima of the diffraction pattern will be matches with this one. So this could not be observed. Likewise, this side is also same scenario. Second minima will be matches with 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 on this. This could not be observed because this is matching with the second minima. So as we found that these 5 peaks are observed in this envelope. Okay, because this minima is matched with this one, because this will be observed here, so it will be suppressed, and this peak will be observed here. That means this peak will be observed at this minima, this peak will be observed at this minima. So in between these minima, what are the peaks? Rest is there. This is the third one, first, second, third, fourth, fifth will be there. Okay, likewise this one, fourth, fifth. That means two peaks will be observed in this envelope. Likewise, these two peaks, two interference peaks will be observed in this envelope. That means in this envelope, what are the peaks? Two peaks. One, two. Two peaks will be observed. Okay. Likewise, this side also same scenario. Two peaks will be observed. Two interference peak will be observed. Likewise, here we can also consider in the higher order minima. Third order minima is matches with ninth order maxima. So it is there is in my figure there is no ninth order, but I can show you somewhat imaginarily. See, this is third order minima of the diffraction. Ninth order means 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. It will be 7, then another will be 8, 7, 8, another will be 9, with 9, matches with 9. So if this minima will be matches with 9th one, then in between that, what are the, this peak is will be not observed, 9th peak is not observed. This one is the 6th peak. So in between 6th and 9th, what are the peaks is observed? That will be 7th and 8th. So 7th and 8th will be observed in this. So, likewise, in this peak also, 7th and 9th peak will be observed. Likewise, for this condition, we can found the middle fringe, middle envelope, the diffraction pattern's middle envelope will be contain 5 interference maxima and rest of the secondary maxima. Or secondary envelopes of the diffraction pattern. These are the envelopes of the diffraction, or we can say these are the secondary maxima of the diffraction, will be contain 2 interference maxima, like this. 2, 2. Okay. 2, 2. Okay, 2, 2 interference maxima will be observed in this envelope. Likewise, for this condition, we can found the resultant intensity distribution due to double slit experiment will be this one. You have to draw this figure here. Where? Here. I drawn somewhat. Let's see. Whenever I give him the note, I drawn only this much. Okay, I extended over somewhat. This is the second maxima of the diffraction, contains 2 interference maxima. This is the second also, contains 2 diffraction maxima. This peak also contains 2 diffraction, 2 interference maxima. Likewise, you have to draw this figure. It will be better. Okay. For which condition? For this condition. For P is equal to 2A condition. Now, another case we have to consider. B is equal to 3A. Okay. This figure you have to draw. This figure. I am going to just just somewhat I am going to be instructive now, how you are going to be draw the, for this case, you just watch. So here, as we know that, as we done in previous, if B is equal to 3A, the M is equal to 4N. Why? Because we know that M is equal to A plus B by A into N, right? Okay, so that will be, M equal to, here A plus B equal to 3A by A into N. Okay, that implies M equal to 4N. So here N is nothing but order of diffraction minima. So we can say first order diffraction, first order diffraction minima is equal to fourth order interference maxima. Likewise, second order diffraction minima is equal to eighth order interference maxima. Likewise, so I am going to show you first one and second one. You just watch. See, if in this case, this figure you have to, for this condition you have to draw and you have to show me. Okay, see, here this is first order is matches with fourth interference maxima. That means first minima will be overlap with fourth maxima, that is 1 2 3 4, fourth maxima. That means here this will be matches with this one. Okay, if this peak will be observed at this minima, then this peak will be cancelled out. Likewise, fourth one, this side also will be cancelled out. Fourth one of this side will be cancelled out. Then what are the peaks will be observed in this envelope? In this envelope, we are going to be observe 1, 2, 3, this side 3, this side 3, middle at 1. That means in this envelope, 7, here they see, 3, 3, 6, this one, 7. That means we can observe intensity, the resultant will be 1, okay, 2, 2, 3, 4, here, 5, 6, 7. So 7 interference peak will be observed for this case in this principal maxima of the diffraction, or the first envelope of the diffraction. So now we have to consider here how many peaks is going to be observed. See, here second order diffraction minima, that will be this one, second order will be matches with eighth one means here we are this fourth one is matches with this one, leave it, we have to leave it. Now this second will be matches with eighth one means this is 5, 6, 7, and this one is another one, it will be here, it will be eighth one. Okay, this will be fourth, fifth, sixth, seventh, eighth. So this peak will be matches with eighth one. So in between this 4th and 8th, how many peaks are there? 3 peaks. That means 3 interference peaks will be observed in this envelope of diffraction. So this is the secondary maxima of the diffraction, or another envelope, or the right side envelope of the diffraction. So inside this diffraction, we can found 3 peaks of interference pattern for the case of B is equal to 3A. That will be like this. 1, 2, 1, 2, 3. That means in all the envelope we can get like this. So this figure, if right side this like this, also left side also same is going to be observed. So you have to draw the detailed figure. Here I have instructed somewhat. You have to draw detailed figure of this case and you have to upload. Okay. So this figure for this one, case 2. So first you watch this video, try to draw this figure. You can pause here. This is the second figure. Okay, this is the second one. This is the second case. Okay, you can pause this video and you can draw this figure. Then after you have to draw for this case in which way I have been instructed. Okay, and you have to upload this figure. And for this case, whatever I have been instructed here, I mean 7 will be observed, then 3 will be observed. Here 5 will be observed, 2 will be observed. You have to upload this figure and this figure for this case. Okay, you have to upload. Watch carefully this video and draw the figure carefully and upload. Okay, thank you.